it's great to be here, and we're very excited to do this with Durjoy. So let's have a huge round of applause for Durjoy Datta, and another one for his smile. Yes. Nice. There's been a lot of chat on your books, and of course, I'm not a reader, so I've not. I'm waiting for the movie to get made. That's where I am with books in general.
But you know, the best part about reading my books is that, as you said, you read one book and then you can say you're well read.
Right.
You've read 15.
That's true.
And a lot of writers copy my books as well. So you've read 30.
Yeah, it's like somebody copies your style of writing, or
which
just
which is very surprising. They copy everything, like even the titles. Like, I was the pioneer in keeping bad titles of books.
Right. Yeah. I can read a few here. One second, I'll just. It's a full sentence. It's.
This was an extra sentence.
Now that you're rich, let's fall in love.
That was a sentence from the book.
So if you had to write Kite Runner, like two people flying kites, one of them is poor.
But to sell the book, you have to say that it is set in post-war Afghanistan.
Yeah.
Otherwise, no.
That's true. But it's and you write a lot of stuff for TV. TV shows you do sometimes.
Yes, I do.
Yeah, you have to.
Yeah, because it's money.
Rent is the biggest motivation to work.
I still live in Malad, so
you're a successful author. You live in Malad.
Yeah, so people, when I say I live in Malad, they think I own Malad.
No,
this is not true.
What does it take to get to fucking South Bombay in this city? Right?
Inheritance.
13 books.
Inheritance.
That's true. Inheritance.
Yeah. Half my day goes in. How much is the fifth highest best-selling author earning in the US, and they all own like cities.
Yeah.
And I don't even own Malad. So,
like, really. Yeah, but to be a successful author, you have to make sure the literacy rate of the country is high, no?
it only matters if you are like in Kerala.
Yeah, if you are writing
Malayalam,
for that,
you are like true.
Yeah. Not that's true. Sell your books in Kerala though.
Very
but
hard.
They read
communist
really communist government, and they read very specific books about Iyengar, yoga, whatever.
Like, but they also like they have a culture of banning books as well.
They have a culture of banning books. Books get banned
all the time. That's the best thing that can happen to a book, because otherwise people don't know about books.
I know. I also got popular when I got death threats. That's how bad my comedy was. Has anyone commented on your dimples while talking about your book in a review, official one?
No, but there's this Instagram profile which says Durjoy's Dimple, which has pictures of me and my right profile. But a lot of journalists also they start their reviews with, so this dimpled author has come out with a new book, because they have been trying to find out reasons why my book works.
And so are you, actually, right?
Haan, same here. I also believe, so Durjoy's dimple is working, why it works. So,
yeah. Whatever the theory people have, just go with it. Yeah. Till the time they are really buying stuff.
Yeah. I don't care. Like, I just keep telling people, keep buying my books. It's not important to read them.
Yeah.
Keep, like...
That's so true.
You have to have a library in your house to impress people, so...
Yeah, like we have one here.
Yeah.
This was someone's shoe rack. Letting you
but
know.
But these are like really expensive books. My books are really cheap.
Yeah. What are your books priced at?
Now it's 200, but now back 200. In the day it was 100.
100 bucks, 200 bucks.
Yeah.
200 bucks. 200 bucks is... Okay. It's a decent experiment, but without any effort. If it was a movie ticket, I'd buy it.
But it's... Yeah, that's true. But it's just not, like, you can't keep your movie ticket in a show rack, which you can do with a book.
Yeah, so most people buy books as props.
A lot of them. Even I do it. But I only buy hardbacks.
Yeah.
Because I'm an author and all, no?
So it looks good.
Yeah, it looks good. Thick books.
Yeah. I went to one author's house. It's a friend of mine, I can't name him. He had like 1300 books in his shelf. I just thought that there's no chance in hell he's read all of them. Because then he would have not made any money in life. Like, he would have just been reading those books. Because what is the reading speed? Like, how much can you read in a day?
But a lot of books repeat themselves. So you just have to buy one and like buy the other books of the same author and you can stack them.
Yeah.
So you can say that I've read it.
Yeah.
I've done it countless times. Yeah.
That's true.
So I say that I'm the favorite author. This guy is my favorite author. I've just read one book of his.
Right.
I can just like mislead people into believing I've read all.
Yeah.
Yeah, because like if you say that I really like Salman Rushdie, no one has read Salman Rushdie.
Yeah, yeah. People can pretend or whatever. Yeah.
And even if someone has read, they don't really like understand it.
So, yeah.
So you can all talk around in circles.
Yeah.
The consciousness of that character is very high and I don't really like the existential problems.
Yeah.
Oh my God. Like the ethos and the pathos of the society that this character was in. Oh yeah. My. Like I was moved.
I am moved right now while you're talking. I think I have read Salman Rushdie. But here's the thing I'd like to tell you about Salman. Confidence is key in life, na? Just bullshit with confidence. One day you'll become Narendra Modi. Some fucking left-wing people. The problem
Modi
with
is awesome though.
Yeah, I think Modi's so. Great. Yeah. Yeah, okay.
Very good.
See, the problem with left-wing in India is they just make great content on news channels. They don't actually, that's not a movement.
No, the left-wing in India cannot agree on topics amongst themselves.
Themselves, yeah. That also happens.
They're so intelligent that they're trying to up themselves.
Yeah, yeah.
Does feminism mean this? No, it means this.
Yeah.
Does religion mean this? No, it means this. My new book is out next month.
Okay.
Just saying.
What's it about?
The Boy Who Loved.
Again.
Yeah.
Just add again. There's no problem. Till the time the mass is consuming it, you Why should not? Keep producing it.
Yeah. We did not stop at like 2 stand-up comics.
No.
We produced more.
100%. Yeah, all so. The time. Because see, the problem is that people, there's demand for this now. Like when somebody was criticizing this TV show, I don't know if you, I hope you've not written it. It's called Hamari Bahu Rajnikant or whatever.
I wish I'd written it.
You really wish you'd written it?
Yeah, because 0.9 TRP on Anti-V is great.
Oh.
I keep trying.
I don't know if you're being sarcastic right now.
No, it's great. Because I used to write a television show that used to like be a competitor to that show.
Oh.
It was called Nagarjuna.
Nagarjuna used to write.
Ek Saap Ki Kahani.
What does a creative person have to do to pay rent in Malad? The world, you know, this world is a tough world to live
very,
in. Yeah.
Very, very
After tough. Selling your soul, you're still poor.
Yeah, yeah. Very difficult. Yeah. And this is not even the worst show that I've written. My real aim in life is to write Sasural Simarka. That is what I really want to write.
Yeah, see, that's what I would want to do if I wanted my extended family's respect. Now they think I'm an idiot.
No, so my family does not know it. Like they are the kind of people who go to Shantiniketan and worship the place Rabindranath Tagore was staying in.
Oh.
So for my extended family, I've still not left my job.
Oh.
So I'm still a marketing analyst for them.
Right.
I don't write.
So for they don't, because they're all like pretentious Bengalis.
Yeah, very.
Very like this didn't cut through. There was no meaning.
No. Like being successful is the least thing that any Bengali parent wants for
their
his or her child.
Yeah.
Like when they're poor, they're happy.
Yeah. You're Bengali, smart, non-pretentious, married, and non-smoker.
Yes.
Are you even Bengali? Does your smile compensate for the easy choice of words?
I think it does a little bit.
Yeah.
Yes.
Someone, one of my friend, I asked her, so I don't read, so I know one or two like hectic readers who just bash everybody.
But would you buy my book if you had seen my picture? If you were inclined that way?
See, I'm more likely to... right, of course. See, I'm more likely to buy your book with the picture, that's for sure. The title is not doing anything. Like, she broke up, I didn't. I just kissed someone else. Now this, like, I think if
you
this
can already claim that you have read the book.
No, I haven't.
That's the story.
You know, if I had, I'd have many more things to say. No, but to be very honest, I haven't. But this, the title of this, just sounds like. Can I guess what the book is about?
Yes, please do.
So I'll just start with all your books, okay? We have an hour to fill.
Yeah.
Of course I love you, till I find someone better. There's a guy who loves this girl, then he finds someone better. But then he feels that this someone better is at a cost which is not love. This is fixation. Then he goes back to the girl who he originally liked. And then the girl says, I accept you back because I always loved you. Somewhat like that?
It's simpler than what you said.
Whoa. So I have put more effort in the premise.
Why?
Than you have in your own work.
Why? It even has less words than you two.
Nice. Second book. So she broke up, so it's very obvious. Yeah. Oh yes, I'm single. And so is my girlfriend. Oh, this is a tricky one.
I took like 2 days writing that.
48 hours?
Enough.
Enough. But is it all from real life stuff?
Like bits and pieces of it.
Bits and pieces
of it. Yeah, earlier when I was young, I had interesting friends, but then they realized my trick that I write about them.
So then they...
So now I'm friendless and I live in Malad. Yeah. Like the first time I fell in love, I was in third, and I thought that I'm going to get married to this person. And that became my day job. Yeah. Like I used to fantasize about various future scenarios when I'm getting married to this girl. Regardless of what, she obviously did not know I existed.
Of course.
So I was thinking, when I'm 40, this girl will come to me running from her abusive husband and with 2 kids, and I will still accept her.
Dude, I am telling you, I had a crush like that when I was 18, and I wished for so many years that she goes through a divorce.
No, that has happened, yeah.
Guess what?
I think I was preparing for IIT so that I could be successful and win that girl over, not realizing that IITians are not desirable.
Yeah. Yeah, that's true. But this girl that I was into, 10 years, I hoped that, oh fuck, one day she should get divorced. Like 24, she got married. I was like, this 100%. But if you're getting married under the age of 25, it's going to end on Satyamev Jayate. Like, there's no... Come on. Like, let's be serious. So I was pretty sure that she'll go through a divorce. But then I forgot about it. Because drugs and other things. And then she called me 2 months ago. Saying she's gotten divorced. I'm not even fucking around. And she said, I'm going for a holiday if you'd like to join.
And what did you say?
And I said, no. Not because I didn't want to go, because my passport was expired. And after removing whatever I've removed on internet, I can't tweet to Sushma Swaraj saying, give me a new passport. There's a problem. I don't think she'll reply saying, yeah, beta, come na. Of course, we are here for you only. So that plan didn't happen. But yeah, she's going to come back soon. And let's see, I'll probably meet her. But it's very difficult to fall in love with someone who has ditched you for like, who's not given you any attention for 2 years and all. Like, then you
but
just,
all my like long-standing crushes end the minute the girl starts to date someone who's not that good.
Huh.
Like, yeah.
Yeah.
Because I saw that, so I was in love with a girl for 6 years. Again, that one-sided Edile Mushkil thing.
Right.
So, she started dating someone really
bad.
I was like, nahi yaar.
Out and out.
Isse toh upar hi hoon main.
Yeah, that's what now. When I get left also, I'm not worried that I got left. I just see who I got left for. Like this guy. No. He thinks washing machine is not dowry. Like this guy. Maruti 800 lene mein kya problem hai? Like that dude. Anyway, coming back to books.
Yes.
Which has been your worst review?
So see, the reviews are various kinds. So the worst reviews are, you're a cancer to humanity. You should stop writing. You're the worst writer that I've ever met. I would kill you. Some things of that sort.
In that order?
Yeah, but but I would take them seriously if they were grammatically correct.
Yeah, they're not
even grammatically correct.
Yeah.
And I'm very angry at those people who pick up my books and then tell me that they don't like it. Why do you write cheesy novels?
Huh.
Now, how obvious can I get with my titles?
Yeah.
You are not going to get like a story about a civil war in a book that says that now that you're rich, fall in love.
Yeah.
And my
You were my crush till you said you love me. What could this book be about?
Yeah. And you read this book cover to cover.
Cover to cover.
And then you say, I did not like it.
Yeah.
Why do you write this?
Yeah, but the problem with these books is, I'm sure if I was a reader, I promise you, I would have read at least 2-3 of these. Because I've seen...
But why would you read 3? Were you hoping that I would get better?
No, just in basis of see, in colleges, I've seen this one thing. I always carried one Sidney Sheldon book in my bag, just to pretend that I read. I didn't even know if he's male, female, nothing. I don't know who this fucker. I just open it in the canteen, read any random page, try to see the stutty and just shut it. Just keep it in my bag.
But my books are not even cool. Like, they wrap it in like newspapers and read it.
Oh.
So like, it doesn't apply.
Oh, it doesn't apply. But your books never was a college thing, like...
They were, I think, like 5 years back.
5 years back.
But not anymore.
Oh, but you're like that. You're basically like, people love you when they're 16, 17. And then they become 25 and then they're like, why did I like that?
No, I think it's like Justin Bieber. You still like it when you're 30. You just don't tell people.
Ah, that's true. See, you collectively told them who they are without taking a shit on them. I should learn this from you. I don't know. I just get rude after a while. It's a problem.
I've made a career out of being the sweet boy.
Yeah. Yeah. Easy to deal with.
Yeah.
Do you get that a lot?
Yeah. Like, even if someone criticizes me, I just say that, thank you for picking up my books. So, मैंने कितना अच्छा लड़का है. एक और खरीद लेते हैं जाके.
Kill with kindness.
Yeah.
But somebody handles.
Not that I'm thinking that.
No, of course
I'm
not.
Thinking.
Who are you, Mahatma Gandhi? Nobody thinks that. No, no. If someone's abusing you, you are abusing them.
Of course, and I'm from Delhi. So.
There's no choice but to like. Yeah. I'm too beating them up in my mind and all.
Yeah. I'm judging like which college are you from, because
yeah.
Once you do engineering, your default setting is, dude, I am from a better college than you are.
Ah.
I am more educated, despite like you could be
but if,
anything.
If you were not a public figure, you would get down to like tera score bata cat ka, mera
score. Haan, yeah, yeah.
Ye mera degree ka photo hai.
Of course, 100%.
I am that petty. That petty.
Yeah, yeah. I even go to their profiles and see ki. कितनी खराब लाइफ है यार बेचारे की. मतलब ही लिव्स इन इंदौर.
आई हैव नथिंग अगेंस्ट इंदौर, जस्ट लेटिंग
इंदौर इज अ ब्यूटीफुल सिटी.
इट्स नॉट एक्चुअली, बट
आई हैव टू से दैट आई हैव रीडर्स इन इंदौर.
यू हैव रीडर्स इन इंदौर. आई हैव नोबडी इन इंदौर. आई हैव सम हेटर्स इन इंदौर. सी, आई डोंट माइंड इंदौर, बट आई जस्ट थिंक they have nothing to offer.
No, they have that food wala gali.
Yeah, yeah.
Chappan gali or something.
Yeah, they'll put sevo in some McDonald's burger and all.
Yeah, it's exactly that.
And then they'll keep disputing. Like, when I made a video about Indore not being Bombay, basically that was the video. And then everybody started tweeting, you know where Lata Mangeshkar and Zakir Khan are born? And I was like, you know where they are right now? That way. Yeah, but I reply sometimes. See, because I also drink. So there's a direct connection on me being like an asshole. Because 2 o'clock in the night, when 3 friends don't pick up because they are married, what are you gonna do? What are you gonna do? Go to your own Facebook and reply to everybody. Thinking that you're being funny, but next day morning you read it and you're just like, "Is pe likes bhi nahi aa raha hai, kya hata hai isko." Yeah, but that happens a lot.
No, but if you're sweet to those comments, you'll find that 5 more of your fans will jump to your defense, and suddenly you'll be the nice guy.
Oh, thanks for
elementary social media.
Fuck, you are really using your education.
Yes.
That's great. Many people accuse you of you cater to non-readers. Why is that a bad thing?
I think I'm doing this nation a very big service
by catering to people who would not usually read.
Yeah, because now they can read my books, step over me and read someone else's books.
Yeah,
that's the best thing. That
and then when they read that book, that's when they start hating you.
Or they'll say that, okay, this book is bad, I think I should go back to the previous author. At least he was cute.
Ah, that's true. But you aspire to Bollywood? Like, you want to do Bollywood movies and stuff like that?
I would like someone to just take my book and make it like a good movie. I do not want to be a part of the process. Like, I cannot deal with that level of humiliation.
Yeah, ideally not.
Like, because writers are at the bottom of the food chain.
Yeah. They're not in the food chain, I think.
They're
just out somewhere. Like. Yeah. They write and people ask them to fuck off and then whatever
but
fucking...
But the review always
some
comes...
Some son of some asshole will come and deliver the line in his own way. Like some Tiger Shroff will come and fuck your book up.
But the review will always be Tiger Shroff tried to salvage this really bad
really
script.
Really bad script, yeah.
Where Tiger Shroff has written the script.
Yeah, they change things. See, the problem is nobody tells all these star kids that they are useless.
Yeah.
Somebody should go tell Tiger Shroff you're a useless asshole.
Nobody is good as a gym trainer.
His best case scenario should be a Zumba instructor. Like, he would have had a studio in Bandra and his five friends would tell him that I look up to you, bro.
I think he would be more successful in the long run as well.
Yeah, and still that makes him more successful than his father, I think. But yeah, you're right. If someone takes your book and makes a movie...
Well, then I'm okay with it.
Yeah, just go watch it on the premiere. Yeah,
as long as I'm getting paid for it. Yeah. Like, that's the only concern any writer has. Where's my next paycheck coming from?
Okay. Yeah, that's true. But your TV thing is going on, so you're not really worried about...
Yeah, TV is great. TV will go on.
TV will keep going on. Yeah. But you have a team...
No, I just do the screenplays, so which is easy to do. So someone else writes the story.
Dialogue someone
I just
else
make
does.
It worse.
Yeah, you just...
It goes to the dialogue writer who makes it even worse and it goes on television.
And it goes on television. Yeah. People think it's great. That's the best
part.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Do you get
like
more
people know because I write for television shows than for my books, which is great.
Kuch Rang Pyar Ke SAP, what's the show about? I know. What would be it?
Love story, saans aa gayi, pasand nahi hai, alag ho gaye, paas mein aa gaye. The same cycle repeats.
But
it's a good show. It's
doing well.
I still want my job.
Yeah, you still want
it's
it.
It's a very good show. It's the best show on television.
Right now.
It's progressive.
I'm going to see it tonight.
Please, today is Sunday. But you can go to Sony Liv.
Yes.
You can type Kuch Rang
Pyar Ke. I can be the only one who went to Sony Liv today. And celebrate that I'm the only one here. Comment there and then reply to my own comment. Hi, I'm on Sony Liv. You will be there replying to me.
Here's the pre-order link to my next book.
Yeah, this is a fun chat. I thought, I read your biography, I thought you'd be boring.
Where did you read my bio? On Wikipedia.
Huh.
I wrote it.
You wrote it? You're more interesting in front of a live audience.
Shit.
If there were people watching you...
I'll put up an audio file, voice of the judge. Where do you do that? You know, national anthem bhi chadate hain, aadha.
National ke baare mein kuch... Just use the word national if you want to go to the college. Otherwise, don't do it. You say the word national, there's another thing which is sedition. This is there. This comes with national, free. But coming back to books.
Yes.
What's next on the books? There's a book coming out next month, but yes. After that?
The sequel to that book. Yes.
You've already planned it.
Yeah, so the pre-order link to The Boy who Loved is out now.
Huh.
The pre-order link to the next book will be out before the book comes out. So please buy it as well. You want to talk about the book, they already know what the story is. They have read the earlier books.
Yeah. No. I don't. I just want to talk about your marketing game is very good. Yeah. Define success. What is success to you?
Success is when my parents finally acknowledge that their son is a full-time writer and he's not planning to go back to his job. So that is...
That has happened already?
That has not happened.
So you're still waiting for validation
in life?
Yeah, I'm
still waiting for validation. So first I waited for validation from reviewers, which did not come. Then I waited for readers to tell me that I'm a good writer. They just stopped acknowledging that they read my books.
But you're still selling?
I'm still selling because like they...
They read your books?
Yeah, because they hide that they're reading my books. Now I'm waiting for my parents to. I think they'll do it when they're old. And they realize ki this is...
Just corner them into doing it, no?
It'll not happen.
Not happening.
No. My dad's an IITian, no? So I'd already disappointed him when I went to Delhi College of Engineering and not IIT.
Hmm.
So
you didn't cut through to IIT?
No. And I remember the word that my mom said. I don't know how it relates to the entire thing, but she told me that you have, that it's a massacre. Like you have collectively ruined Datta family's name that you could not get through IIT.
Wow, that's just hectic. Dude, my parents were so much nice because I failed the 12th standard and fucked off. And still my father was like, "Theek hai, I guess." Main kya hi bolu isko? Maine padh likh ke kaun sa ukhad liya? Yeah. But that's just hectic. You, matlab, you grew up in so much pressure.
But I also believed it to be true.
Hmm.
That was the level of my conditioning, that you have to go into IIT to be a successful person, to be a person.
Mm.
So for me, it was okay. Like IIT,
I know so many IITians who are not to be respected all.
Yeah, I make it a point to find, like, seek, search and destroy IITians.
Yeah. Yeah. That, I was never impressed by people from IIT.
Same, yeah.
Same, they're fucking never impressed. And plus, I was so happy that my judgment was right because few of them now are turning out to be molesters. So I'm just like, I was always right about them. Like,
it's fine.
IIT has nothing to do with it. It's my judgment. If you had to go back in time and change one of the books that you'd written, which one would it be?
I would change the first one because it encouraged me to write the others.
That's a great answer. No, because the first one, if it was different...
Yeah, because see, after my first book came out, the publisher told me, write anything. We'll just slap a cover on it and sell. And I was in my MBA college at that point in time and I was like, the writing is not something that I'll do. So I just wrote. 50,000 words. I stopped where 50,000 words were over. I sent it to a great book. What's the title? Now that you're rich, let's fall in love. Bestseller. So that's how it worked. So
this doesn't say... It says a lot about the way you work.
And also how my publisher
but
works.
But it says a lot about the people of this country. Like it says a lot about what they are consuming. Because main say casually kuch likh raha
hu. But my second book is my worst performing book.
Yeah?
Yeah. So people did catch on to
it.
My subterfuge.
Yeah. Because you didn't put any effort.
Absolutely not.
Yeah. So people saw.
Yeah, people saw through it.
Saw through it. And that happens because money is involved. So they are careful.
Yeah.
That is always true. But let's talk about your TV shows. Oh, there's another interesting thing. You got married how many years ago? 2 years ago?
1 year.
1 year ago. Yeah. And you asked your wife out by making a hashtag trend on Twitter.
Yeah.
It's a very unconventional way of...
Yeah, I mean, it wasn't intentional. It just
trended.
Yeah, it just trended. And one of the first texts that I got was from my sister. It was like, which PR agency have you employed?
But I had not.
Because I started off with Instagram. And I had like a very limited following there. So I started there.
Huh.
And the people started telling me that, why don't you go to Twitter and do it? So I said, I'll do it.
Sure.
And within minutes, it caught on and it started trending. And there were Huffington Post and India Times Post, which were saying that, look at this boy harassing a girl. Bullying her into marrying him.
With your dimples as a photo, like this boy harassing girls.
I'm sure they would have chosen a creepier picture.
They would have chosen a picture.
Of which there are many. But they had no idea that we were getting married next week anyway.
Oh, so this whole thing was just, I want to make you happy.
Because she has spent the last 8 years in Dubai. So she has hung out with a lot of Firangi people. Where
there's
proposing
this whole thing
is
ke.
Thing. Haan. Thing is a big... sort of deal.
Yes.
So she wanted it from me.
Right.
So I did it like...
So you did the Twitter.
Yeah.
I love you. Hashtag trending.
No, I wrote a paragraph for
her. You wrote a paragraph. Yeah. With grammatically correct, all of that.
I think there were people who
was
were
there an exclamation mark? Just like your titles. Your titles.
I think there were many.
There were many exclamations.
I love you. Not I love you. There were many. But there were like people correcting my grammar there.
You know, I'd use this idea, but for when I need a divorce. ask it online, right? Like, please fuck off from my life. And hashtag, leave Kunal Kamra alone.
You could say the same word thrice as well. If you were from a different religion.
If I was. But this is a good idea. I'll save it for my divorce. I really mean it. If I'm going through it, then I will. It'll be like this. Your current favorite book?
My current favorite book. I think I read The Ground Beneath Her Feet by Salman Rushdie. Like, I reread it a few days back and I really like it.
You had to reread
it. Please don't ask what the book is about because I don't know.
You had to reread it or you reread it?
Yeah, because I was given the first Salman Rushdie book, which was Satanic Verses, printouts, when I was in 8th standard.
Right.
Read it.
Huh.
As an assignment by my parents.
Right.
I did not get it. So a lot of Salman Rushdie books, I read it when I was really young.
Right.
And I did not get any of it.
Right.
So now I have to reread them to get what he's saying. And I'm thinking I'll have to reread them after 5 years as well.
Yeah. Kya kehna cha raha hai wala scene.
So you just skip like paragraphs. Achha, yahan pe kuch nahi ho raha, kuch nahi ho raha.
You glaze through someone. Yeah. Dude, he's got fatwas and all. At least read his entire book.
Fatwas. Sona Nigam pe bhi fatwa hai. Fatwa is now devalued.
Yeah.
It's very easy to get a fatwa. You will get a fatwa today if you say something.
Yeah, but I'm sure they'll make spelling mistakes.
You can read Urdu.
I can't. But no, fatwas come in Urdu or what?
I don't know.
Then how would Sonu Nigam even find out?
He must have.
He would call, hey Atif, padna kuch bheja hai koi ball.
But he called a guy to like shave him off in his house.
Yeah,
like
his
friend of his.
That's. He got a haircut that he paid for instead of getting 10 lakhs. Yeah. That's just a bad deal. I don't know. But yeah.
If you have to write a really successful commercial book in India, you have to give them a sad ending.
Oh.
Nicholas Sparks.
Really?
Who cracked it like really long back. Like the more people who die at the end, the better your book will do.
Like a Bengali film. Bengali films also have this sad ending kind of thing.
I've not seen.
You've not seen Bengali films?
No.
That's why your parents are not acknowledging you. That's what's upsetting them. Just go watch Pathir Panchali thrice. Like, morning, evening, night. And then just blurt out whatever you got to your parents. Like, come here, I want to tell you about this film. I just can't imagine how it would be if my father gave me a book. That would have never happened
notes,
in my family. Huh?
They are spark notes. You can just like read the summary of the book and tell them that you have read it.
Ah.
I do it before every lit fest.
Yeah. Lit fest. Have you got heckled at a lit fest?
So see, because I'm very sweet to people, like whenever a bad question comes, there are 10 people in the crowd who already silence at me, that person.
Yeah.
Plus I'm really sweet to hecklers as well.
Yeah.
So because I don't tell that, okay, I've written the best book in the world. I say that I've written the worst book in the world. So whatever you're saying, I know.
Yeah, because what can they tell you that you already don't know?
You say these things, I'll say something worse.
Yeah.
Match up to that.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Criticism wise also, I've kind of thought through the worst things that they could tell me.
Yeah, so it's what's irritating is...
So whatever they say mostly is a compliment, I think.
You've already set the bar so low.
Yeah, I've set the bar very low. Like if I was commenting on my videos, it would be much more brutal than people commenting on my videos. People are still nice. They say some silly things. Like, yeah. I'll kill you if I see you and all, but... I don't think they mean it. I don't think anyone has the time
to like...
You
won't know till the time you find out.
Yeah. And then once you find out, then it's
then
over.
It's inconsequential.
Like then there's no suspense. But yeah, there are a lot of like... Yeah, there's one particular person who trolls me every morning. It's been 42 days. And he keeps writing to me, Bharat Mata ki jai bol, Bharat Mata ki jai bol, Bharat Mata... And I'm like, kaise par? Facebook pe? Aisa like, comment section mein, like... कुछ होने तो दे यार कुछ ओलंपिक मेडल आएगा इंडिया कुछ जाके कुछ तो कुछ लेजिट लगना चाहिए ना ऐसे ही सुबह को उठ के भारत माता की जय थोड़ा लेजिट तो होना चाहिए ना मैं ऐसा लगेगा मैं सरकास्टिकली बोल रहा हूँ
शिवाजी का स्टैचू तो बन रहा है ना
हाँ शिवाजी का स्टैचू बन रहा है
like
पर बना नहीं है ना अब तक
पर
अब तक तो प्लान है सिर्फ पैसे ले लिए पब्लिक से प्लान है वो लाइक वो स्टार्टअप फॉर्मेट है ये गवर्नमेंट भी लाइक पहले सब फंडिंग जमा करते हैं फिर डिसाइड करते हैं क्या करना है पर कुछ बने तो सही दैट्स व्हाट मेट्रो लाइन में देख रहा हूँ वैसे कि मेरा ग्रैंडफादर 10 साल रुका सीलिंग के लिए वो एक्सपायर हो गया सीलिंग नहीं बना उसका एक मारुति 800 था उसने बोला था मैं लेके जाऊंगा सीलिंग पे जब बनेगा ये वो फिर नहीं बना अभी क्या करेगा मतलब अभी वो फेज में सोचना 10 साल आदमी सीलिंग के लिए रुका है अभी मेरे दादा को कोई फेसबुक पे बोले अभी भारत माता की जय बोल व्हाट द फक डू यू मीन इजंट इट लाइक लेजेंड या बट हेट इज एन इमोशन इज व्हाट आई हैव रियलाइज्ड इफ यू कैन इवोक हेट एंड लव इट्स फाइन But indifference is a problem.
True.
Like if people are indifferent to your work, I think that means it's not impactful in any way. So if like people are hating you, I think evoking hate is much more difficult than love.
No, because have you noticed that we like as a reading community, we spend more time talking about books that we hate.
Yeah.
Rather than talking about books that we like.
True.
So if 10 people talk about that, I really hate his book, right. I'm okay with it.
Yeah, totally. Yeah. You know, how many times have we gone and written a review on Zomato when we've liked the food?
Yeah. Have we only rated
like versus when we've hated Punjab Grill, this is not done. I will come there and I will break your glass. Who's this person? We are shut now, sir. Come. Yeah, nobody. Yeah, you're right. Hate. But see, I get hate is fine. Indifference is the problem. Like, if people are just like not giving a fuck about your work, then you're just like, my God, what's going on? That's why the movies turn out like that. Vada pav aur chaas pe picture likhega to aise.
And writers are like, they're so not used to this treatment. They're like, haan, kahin bhi.
Kahin bhi.
Like anything free is good.
What's your form of chilling? That long pause gave it away. It's same as my form of chilling.
Like a distance.
But it's just that I say it.
An even more difficult question would have been, when do you work?
Yeah, when do you work? Never, almost.
Star, very long pause, star. I don't work.
Yeah, but if there was an option where you had everything that you have and a continuous supply of it, and you just didn't have to do anything, would you
opt? I was still right.
You'd still write?
Yeah,
I'd stop.
Yeah, no, but I was still right. Like, I might be the worst writer in the world, but I was still right.
Yeah. But I think if I've got everything, if the economics are stopped, I'll just be like, bus ho gaya. Because who doesn't want to, like, who wants to, like, wear your shoe? Unless you're changing the world, which I'm not doing. Like, I'm not even close. So why just wear your shoes, go out, pretend to like people, like, all of that process.
Yeah.
Around work
you'll
is too much.
You'll never make it big in Bollywood.
Half
of it is like pretending to like people.
Yeah, that's true. I just keep seeing dishonesty throughout. Like, people in Bollywood are dishonest about each other's movies. Like,
yeah, how can you
this
tell?
It's like, Karan, I really liked your film. And Karan's like, yeah, when I made it, I was thinking, I was like, tumhara kaam public ko chutiya banana, ek dusre ko nahi. Like, like, they're just a pretentious bunch of assholes.
So, when I was writing my first book, I was really stuck at how my protagonist should look like and what should be her name like. So, at that point in time, there was awkward. So there was a friend's friend who was my current wife. So I stalked her and thought, oh, this is, the name is also good and she looks gorgeous. So I took her name and I described her in the first book. Cut to 3 years later, she had read the 3 books that had come out with her name and her description. So she reached out to me and said that, do you want to meet? And I was like, okay. And she was like that, of course I did not tell her that I had used her name and description or whatever. And she said that, I've already been dating you in my head for the last so many years, would you want to make it real? I was like, why not? So that's how, and then we started dating. So yeah, that's how we started.
Wow. That's so much effort. Why don't you just ask her out for coffee? That's how it's done.
Out of my league.
She was out of your league. Yeah. When has that stopped any man?
Yeah, true.
Like, that's true. But that brings us to the end of this session of Clueless Critic. Like Books and Toast on Facebook. It's a small community. It will never do well, I think. But it needs your support. Like, follow them on Instagram, follow them on Twitter, subscribe to their YouTube channel, and the videos from this conversation will be on YouTube. So again, go share that video. And all your life, every day when you wake up, think about books on toast. What is books on toast doing today? Then start your day. Okay. And thank you so much. Can we hear it again for Durjoy Datta? Yes. Thank you.